Good morning and welcome to the morning meditation. Today we'll be looking at being mindful with our guided meditation. And we'll also start with opening, as always, our Wiraculture, our sacred space around us. So bring your hands together into the prayer position. Drawing down into your heart. Feeling your breath. And then in the next in-breath, bring your hands up into this eighth chakra, this eighth energy field, like a sun, like a globe, this energy, and then spread it all around us. Bring the sacred space all around us here now. Bring it all the way around, like a cocoon of light, all around. Ah, that's good. And now we're going to open over you, the class, and people watching this live or in the future. So bring your hands together up and then spreading it out over you as well, making the sacred space stronger as we spread it over each other. Wonderful. That's good. Now we'll start with our, we call our death arrow, our fire stick. We're going to blow any negative feelings or emotions in here, and then we're going to put them to the fire. So it's a small fire ceremony that we're performing to release any of those negative energies that have been coming to us, that's been happening for a while, and blow them in here with the intensity that you need. If you don't have one, you can have a toothpick, roll a bit of paper, you can do it later, or you can, with intention, you can use my one as well. Take it in your hand and then imagine holding it and blowing those emotions in. Think of the thought you want to get rid of. And blow them into the stick. Another thought or emotion to come in can be up to about 5, 6, or 7. When you're ready, we'll put it to the fire. Always being careful with the fire. Allowing all of those thoughts and feelings and emotions to be released back to the universe. Different flames, different types of releasement. Release back to the light. Send your fingers when it gets closer. Lots of different ones here this morning. Gone. Final release. Letting go. Good. Now sitting comfortably, either on a cushion, on the floor, on a chair, lying down. Have your hand tends to be flat on your knees, or you can be working with your different energy centers through your system as well. Whatever feels comfortable to you. That's good. Closing eyes, going within. Coming aware. Aware of of your breath, wherever you're breathing. Like, allow this relaxation now to come in and down through your head, down from your body, from the top of your head, all the way down to the tips of your toes. Bring and allow this relaxation now down your head, down into your forehead, and your face, past your eyes, your nose, around your jaw, to your chin, down the back of your head, to your neck. The muscles in and around your head and neck now relax. Bring this down into your shoulders now, down to your arms, through your elbows, to your wrists, out the ends of your fingertips. Now bring and allow that down the front of your body, your chest now down to your abdomen. Now down your back, upper back, middle back, lower back, relaxed. Now from the end to your waist, your hips. Now down your legs, down your thighs, front and back of your thighs, to your knees. Knees down into your ankles. To your feet, out the ends of your toes. Relaxed and letting go. Aware of your breathing, aware of the sensations of the breath coming in and out of your nose. Feeling sensations of the tummy, your stomach expanding and contracting with each breath. And just breathing a little bit deeper now, without it being forced. Just breathing in a little bit more. Breathing out a little bit further. That's good. Relaxed. Now we go. Breathing for the count of two. Breathing in for two. Out for two. Hold for two, out for two. Here we go, breathing in. One, two, hold. One, two, breathing out. One, two, hold. One, two, breathing in. One, two, hold. One, two, hold. One, two, hold. In, one, two, hold, out, hold, in, out, last time, in, count of four, breathing in, two, hold, out, and again, breathing back to your normal breathing rhythm. Be aware of those sensations of the breath coming in and out of your mouth. As you're relaxing there now, I'd like you to visualize, picture, imagine a light coming out from the top of your head, coming all the way around your body. This light is a special light, the color of the rainbow. Any color you choose could be a bright color or a dull color. All around you like a cocoon of light. This is special light. This light is full of peace, love, light, healing and protection. All the way around you there, now coming from the top of your head. Now we're going to expand, spread this light out like sound waves moving out from the source. Spread this light out now, out around the space or the room that you're now in. Now out further around your home, your apartment, your building that you're in. Spreading this peace, love, light, healing and protection in now. That's good. Now taking it around your neighborhood, spreading this around, spreading this out like those sound waves moving out. This peace, love, light, healing and protection. And now around your village, your town, your city, spreading this out now. And now your nation, your country, spreading this peace, love, light, healing and protection there now. Coming up from the top of your head, this light, the colour, spreading it out. And now taking that out further into neighbouring nations, neighboring countries, and they're seeing it spread all the way around Mother Earth, around Pachamama, Gaia. This peace, love, this light, healing and protection coming from you, going all the way around now. Now I'd like you to send extra energy to all the areas of conflict around the world. The ones that we're hearing about now. And the ones that we're not hearing about that are going on, that have been hidden from us. All the conflicts around the world. Could be major ones like war, with death and destruction. Can be neighbours. Conflicts, work conflicts, sending extra energy to the areas that you know, sending this light, this peace, love, this healing and protection in now. And now sending this out and around from Pachamama, from Mother Earth, out into the universe as far as it'll go. This peace, love, this light, healing and protection. Now, melting away. Being mindful and present with negative emotions. In this exercise, we'll share how mindfulness can help you become however you want to be, rather than simply reacting to the stresses of work, news, and responsibilities. You're now being more comfortable with meditation and with mindfulness practice. You may also feel the potential for what mindfulness can do for you. For example, what would it be like if you weren't worried about work or your mortgage, or feeling overwhelmed all the time, or feeling tired from all of your chores? What if instead of feeling overwhelmed, bored or stressed, you're able to step back and say, ah, okay, that's overwhelm. Or, okay, that's worry. Okay, that's just stress. I've got this. I've got this. Rather than saying, I am stressed, or rather than feeling as though you're in the middle of it all, instead just recognizing that, okay, that's a thought, or that's a feeling. For some of you, that may sound weird or crazy. You may well think, yeah, but you don't know my crazy situation. And you're right, I don't. But remember, it's really important to see that this practice of mindfulness takes time for change to happen. But change does happen. For people who are successful at what they do, it's a habit of a lifetime. Or at least a habit for a good few years. We're not just talking about doing better at work or feeling less stressed. This is about living on your own terms. This is about choosing how awake and present you want to be for the life you're living right now. This is about enhancing your presence, your wisdom, your compassion, and your effect on the world, inside of you and outside of you, to the absolute best of your ability. How do you want to be when you're older? Mindful. Every time you realize you're distracted and you're taking the time to acknowledge it, something is changing. Not only in thoughts and consciousness, but also in the brain itself. If you experience stress, overwhelm, or anxiety a lot, then it can be really uncomfortable, and you'll probably want to get as far away from it as possible. And that's understandable. But it's also really important to acknowledge that you can't stop anxiety. Everyone's tried it. It doesn't work. What you can do is develop a different type of relationship to it, where you eventually feel at ease with it. And potentially, you can start to embrace it as a way of further understanding the mind. So as you move through your day to day, remember that idea of being aware, simply being aware, being present for the sensations in your body. Whenever you remember to do this, it's quite an amazing thing, because all of a sudden you're actually present. Again, it's as though you cut the negative feedback loop. You step out of the loop of thinking, which fuels the emotions of stress and overwhelm. And instead, you're actually present with your body and what you're doing. On the one hand, it's a very ordinary feeling. And yet, on the other hand, it's an extraordinary feeling. Extraordinary. Because we experience it so really. Just remember to be present. Simply being aware. Excellent. Well done. So, to recap, if you experience stress, overwhelm, or anxiety a lot, then it'll be really uncomfortable and you'll want to get as far away from it as possible. That's understandable. It's also really important to acknowledge that you can't stop anxiety. Everyone's tried it and it doesn't work. What you can do is develop a different type of relationship to it, where you eventually feel at peace with it. And potentially you can start to embrace it as a way of further understanding the mind. So as you move through your day today, remember that idea of being aware. Simply being aware. Being present for the sensations of your body and in your body. Of being you and who you really are. Being mindful. And as you're being mindful, just bring yourselves back to the breath. Being mindful of who and what you really are. Feeling that breath moving in and out of your body. Relaxed and letting go. You to be. Take some time to think about all the things you're grateful for in your life. Take some time now, and time to think of your intention for practicing mindfulness meditation, your intention for today, your intention for the days ahead. Your intention for the weeks ahead, months, years. You're sitting here in our sacred space and join us. Serenity as we protect ourselves from the static of the world. Sensing the quiet and stillness that pervades the space. This amplified space as we've expanded this radiant orb around us and we rest within it. Enjoying this peacefulness and this relaxation here now. If you'd like to carry on this meditation, please just turn the volume down. Carry on. If not, in a moment I'll count from 1 to 5, and when I reach the count number 5, number 4, I'll say the word up and you'll be fully aware, feeling calm, rested, refreshed, relaxed, you're feeling wonderfully good. One, slowly, calmly, easily and gently return to your full awareness once again. Two, every muscle and nerve and fibre in your body be loose and limp and relaxed, you're feeling wonderful. Three, from head to toe, you'll be feeling perfect in every way. Physically perfect, mentally perfect, emotionally calm and serene. And before your eyes, with your sparkling clears of bathe in a cool spring mountain stream. On the next number day, we fully aware, feeling calm, rested, refreshed, relaxed, hey, feeling wonderfully good. Wonderfully good. Number five, up. Take a deep breath, fill up your lungs, stretch, open your eyes slowly. Focus on something in the room and allow yourself to come back to your full awareness. Well done. Well done. Lovely meditation this morning. Good on you. Well done. And now we're going to close our sacred space around us, around the class first, and then our own individual one. So we're going to scoop it up by wrapping up the folds of a blanket. We're going to scoop it up all around us and bring it back up to our eighth chakra, this eighth energy field, golden globe of light. You start to feel the tingling the more you practice this, the more sensitive to it. And then in your own time, and only what's for your highest good, bring this down, this energy down, this light down into your body. And then take extra, a little bit extra down to Pachamama for her much needed healing, and to Mother Earth. And then wrapping up our own world culture, bringing us up into this orb of light all around us. Again, when it was for your highest good, this time bring it down into your energy centers, down through your body. And again, extra from Pachamama for Mother Earth. Well done. If you have time, we'll make time this morning for some journaling. Take some time there to jot down, you know, those thoughts or feelings we had through the meditation. And to reset your chakras, remember, in the shower, go around anti-clockwise. Normally we start at the first chakra, but you can't see that one. 5 or 6 times. Imagine pulling out any sludge, washing it under the shower, moving up to the next one, anti-clockwise. Washing into the shower, going through all 7 chakras, and then resetting them in a clockwise direction. So going around at least 7 times, and I'd like to swirl as it comes out from the body. Up to the next one, 7 times, and then allow it to come out, and go through all your chakras. Yeah, all of them from there in this one. Yeah, it's coming out. Resetting all your energy centers, all your chakras. Have a wonderful day. Lovely to spend some time with you. Namaste. Aho.